Hello students, in today's lecture video, we shall discuss about stone masonry and different technical terms related to stone masonry. So first, we shall begin with the major types of stone based on its formation. So building stone is a natural engineering material and stone is obtained from rock by applying certain disintegration techniques like manual quarrying and blasting, etc. Stones obtained from rocks are irregular in shape and size and thus need proper tracing before using for construction purpose. Igneous rock, sedimentary rock and metamorphic rock. Igneous rocks are formed by the solidification of molten rock such as volcanic activity, and the best example of igneous rock is granite. Sedimentary rocks are formed from silt, marine life and rocks that have been deposited by running water. And the examples of sedimentary rock are limestone and sandstone. Metamorphic rocks are those rocks which has been changed by pressure, heat or moisture. So if igneous or sedimentary rock have been changed due to pressure, heat or moisture, then it is known as metamorphic rock. The examples of metamorphic rocks are marble and slate. Then let's now discuss about stone masonry and its uses. Stone blocks laid with cement or lime mortar in a systematic manner forming a structural mass which can resist load without disintegration is called stone masonry. Stone masonry is used for the construction of walls, foundation, columns, lintels, arches and other components of structures. If abundantly available, it can serve as an economical building material, keeping in the view the dressing cost and time of construction. Undressed or rounded shaped stone masonry with insufficient mortar is disastrous in earthquake, hazard areas like Balakot and Abbottabad, etc. Here you can see some of the slides showing the stone masonry. Here you can see another slide showing brilliant and excellent stonework. And here you can see the slide showing the Machu Picchu stone masonry. It is situated at 2430 meter above the sea level. Here you can see the slide showing the Great Wall of China. In this slide you can see Taj Mahal, which is made up of white marble. Here you can see the picture of Lahore Fort, Pakistan. So now we shall discuss about the technical terms related to stone masonry. First one is block in course. The course of stones provided on the top of cornice to hold down and prevent the cornice from overturning is known as a block in course. Next one is corbel, a short stone cantilever jutting from the face of the wall to form a bearing is known as corbel. Next one is cornice, a projection which crowns a wall, any horizontal division of a wall or an architectural feature is known as cornice. Bedding plane, the plane along which the stones can be separated into different layers is known as the bedding plane. So here you can see this is the corbel. This is known as cornice. This is stone cornice to divert the water from stone below. Drip stone, A projecting molded stone having its undersurface coated to prevent rainwater flowing back to the wall is known as the drip stone. So here you can see the drip mold at opening prevents the water moving along the underside of stone. Jamb, it is the part of wall which is at the side of an opening. Grouting, the process of working out of the mortar cement slurry over stone or bricks to fill their joints and cracks etc. is called grouting. Moldings, ornamental features given to the construction members to improve their appearance is known as moldings. Templates, pieces of stones placed under the ends of beams to distribute the load over large area is known as templates. The bond stone, so the stone extending through the entire thickness of wall to increase its lateral stability is known as the trap or bond stone. Parapet, a long wall constructed around the terrace of building having a flat roof is known as parapet wall. Coping, it is a special course provided at the top of wall preventing penetration of rainwater from entering the wall. Quinces, so stones are larger than those of which the wall is composed or better shaped and forming the corners of walls or doors and window openings. If they project, they are described as raised and rusticated if having chamfered angles. Frieze, the stone course provided below the cornice is known as frieze. Spalls, the chips of stone used for filling the hollow spaces in the stone masonry are called spalls. Buttress, the stepped masonry projections which is intended to provide lateral strength to the wall is known as buttress. String course, a distinctive course or band continued across a whole facet which may be defined by its position. For example, seal course. So with this we have finished the different technical terms related to stone masonry. So if you have got any doubts, you can ask me in the official WhatsApp group.